Welcome back to another episode of War in Cali. In this episode, I'ma detail the story of Tommy Ross, aka Joker from A-Tray Gangsta Crip. Joker would grow up in South Central LA in a two-parent home and was the middle of five siblings. Joker's mom was known for being a church-going woman who worked as a nurse, and Joker's dad, he was a minister. Joker grew up in a strict family and grew up going to church. He was a church kid growing up. His parents had dreams of their kids being ministers themselves or just being heavily involved in church. Early on in his childhood, Joker would start to rebel and resent his father. With Joker not being allowed to do anything but go to church, he wanted to play sports and have his own life, but he wasn't allowed to. Being in church so much, Joker didn't have a typical life of many youths in South Central. He had both parents, and they were working class people, compared to many others who didn't have both parents or didn't have a solid foundation in their homes. This type of situation converted many youths into future gang members. But one day in his early childhood years, gang members would change Joker's life as well. Joker would be at a taco stand getting some food when a group of young blood gang members approached him, asking Joker where was he from. Joker not being in the gang, he replied nowhere. This still wouldn't leave him safe. The young bloods jumped him and took his food. This made Joker from that point change. He was 13 years old, and this left a lasting impact on him, of him never wanting to be messed with again. Joker would gain a friend who happened to be from A-Tray Gangsta Crip. The A-Tray Gangsters are one of the most known sets in LA and were established in the 70s, and later became one of the most dangerous and well-respected sets. Joker would be amazed by the gang lifestyle, and it was like something he never saw before. He was around brotherhood, the music, the clothes, the women, and even the money. They were all exciting to Joker. Being only 13, he loved the new lifestyle, which was a different world from being a church boy. At 13, Joker got his official put on with the A-Tray Gangsters after hanging out with them for a while. Joker got the name Joker after the A-Trays gave him that name from the villain from Batman. Joker would start doing a lot of activities to get his name known, from fighting, tagging walls, committing robberies, and a lot of other things that would lead to him getting arrested a few times. Joker was just following the lead of his big homies, who was his influences, but he wanted to be well known more and have more hood fame than his homies. By 1979, the A-Tray Gangsters were an established gang, with many allies being other Crip hoods, and their main rivals being several blood gangs throughout LA. But on one day, that would all change. The Rolling 60 Crips and the A-Tray Gangsters were allies at one point, but they later became rivals after one day. The two groups would meet up, and they would run a fade, but this would all lead to a young Rolling 60 Crip being killed. This would change the foundation of LA gangs, making new alliances like the Neighborhood Car and the Gangsta Car, which will lead to several other wars, and the A-Tray Gangsters in the 60s being one of the most deadly. One day, Joker will be in a liquor store in his hood, when he seen a young man come in a liquor store who looked like a gang member. Joker greeted him thinking he was from an allied gang with him being in his hood, but he would be completely wrong. The other man was from Rolling 60 Crip, and his name was Mumbles. Mumbles himself was a well-known and respected gang member. Mumbles banged Rolling 60 Crip on Joker, and this was the wrong thing to say to Joker. Joker went to his car, got his gun, and even waited for Mumbles to walk out the store. Once Mumbles was out the store, Joker shot him multiple times, taking Mumbles' life. Many witnesses would see the shooting, and they would pick Joker out as the shooter.
I was inside a liquor store in my neighborhood on Florence and Normandy. Florence and Normandy was the site where the LA riots took place in 1992, where you see one of the guys pulling this white older man from his truck and beating him. That was the neighborhood that I came from. See, this brother come in, and he has on blue 501 Levi's. He got blue and black Pumas. He has a blue sweatshirt on, and he has, like, this chain earring in his ear. He has waves in his hair. He also has a lot of tattoos. So I knew he was a gang member. I knew he was a Crip. I thought that maybe he was from a gang that was nearby who we shared an affiliation with. And I say, what's up? And he like,
what that West Side Rolling 60s like?
Now, that was the worst thing he could have said to me at that time because I was at the height of my career as a gangbanger. I was age 19. I had already been to camp. I had already been to youth authority. I had already been involved in many altercations between A-Trays and 60s. So when he did that, I felt disrespected. So when he said, what that West Side Rolling 60 like? I said, what? F Rolling 60. Fool, this A-Tray Gangsta. I see an opportunity to go outside. So I do a beeline to the door. I go out to the car I was in, and I retrieve the weapon that I had. When he came outside the liquor store, it happened so fast, it was automatic. I didn't really think about it. I shot him. I shot him 5 times. His eyes. I remember his eyes. His eyes were really big. His eyes were really wide open. I seen terror in his eyes. I saw fear on his face. The person I shot outside the liquor store was Stanford Burson, and he died for no reason. He died basically over words.
That shooting happened on September 7th, 1985. Joker would go into hiding to evade the police, but just 4 days later, Joker's world would be rocked. He would get a call that his mother and his little brother would be killed by the Rolling 60s. The Rolling 60s would get to drop on their house, and they would take revenge. The Rolling 60s would go up to Joker's parents' house and knock on the door. When his little brother opened the door, they shot and killed him. Joker's mom would run to see what happened and see what all the commotion was about. She would end up shot and killed herself. Before Joker could ever get revenge for his family, he would be arrested for killing Mumbles. He couldn't even attend his brother and mother's funeral. The closest thing he got to their funeral was receiving their obituaries. Joker gave his all to his gang and received life. He lost his family and even some friends. After a while, he got less visits and less people to pick up the phone, and also less contact with the outside world. Only thing on Joker's mind was revenge and getting the people who got his family, but that never got to happen. Joker's brother and mother's killers were later arrested, and one of the killers was a well-known Rolling 60 Crip named Petey Wack, who I'd done a previous episode about. Petey Wack is still currently in prison. By 1996, Joker would become a Muslim and change his name to Shakur. Joker's lifestyle would become a lot different. He became a person trying to make a lot of steps in his life behind bars for the bettering of himself and others. Joker would be a part of several groups teaching youth about his past in prison and things that he was going through, and hoping to lead them to a different path that he was at. 2012, Joker helped launch a radio program at San Quentin, which he was a big part of producing stories and also having his own podcast. 2017, Joker received an award for excellence in journalism by the Northern California Chapter of Society for Professional Journalism. Joker also graduated college and received a degree in general studies at Patton College. He also was the class of 2019 class valedictorian. Joker would file several appeals, but wouldn't be released until 2022. After serving 36 years in prison, Joker would finally be released. Joker is now in his late 50s and is pushing peace and trying to start his life over. He's a changed man now and trying to be the best person that he could be. This will conclude this episode. If you haven't already, make sure you check out my previous episodes. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.